I'm Dr. Pratap Nekode. Welcome to your favorite channel, PBN Science Study.
Hello dear students, in this video we will study Fabaceae family. We will see morphological as well as floral characters of Fabaceae family. Dear students, actually Fabaceae is subfamily of bigger family Leguminaceae. Leguminaceae is the second largest family under Dicotyledoni. Leguminaceae consists of about 600 genera and 14,000 species. Members of Leguminaceae grows under extreme diverse conditions of soil and climate. They are most abundant in temperate and warm condition. The bigger family Leguminaceae is divided into subfamilies. The first is Fabaceae or Papilionaceae family. Second is Cisalpinaceae family and third is Mimosaceae family. We will see this family later on. In this video, we are going to concentrate on morphological and floral characters of Fabaceae family. We will see salient features or the characters of Fabaceae family. These are some of the photographs of Fabaceae family members. First of all, we will see distribution. Fabaceae family consists of about 500 genera and 10,000 species. It is widely distributed in warm temperature region throughout the world except in the Arctic regions. Now, habit of Fabaceae family members. The plants are herb, as you can see here, or shrubs or tree or climber. So some of the members of Fabaceae family are also the climbers, as you can see here. Then, regarding the morphological feature, first we will see leaves. Leaves are simple or imperipennately compound. In this diagram, we can see imperipennately compound leaf. Imperipennately compound means the total number of leaflet are always odd because at the end there is a single leaflet without pair. And so, this type of the leaves, they are known as imperipennately compound leaves. Leaves are stipulate, means stipules are present. Leaves are modified partly or completely into tendrils. As you can see here, this is the leaf of Physum sativum or garden pea. Here we can see that the leaflet are completely modified into tendrils. So these are the tendrils. This tendril is actually produced by replacing leaflet here. The stipules produced are often foliaceous. Foliaceous means leaf-like. This is the diagram which shows foliaceous stipule. So here stipule is present, but it looks like the leaf. Dear student, now we will see floral characters of Fabaceae family. Various members of Fabaceae family shows variation in the inflorescence. Some of the members shows solitary inflorescence. Some shows raceme type of the inflorescence. Here, this is the inflorescence of alfalfa plant. Here you can see the raceme type of the inflorescence. In raceme type, older flower, they are at the base and younger flower are at the apex. Panicle type of the inflorescence is also seen in case of Dalbergia, as well as axillary head type of the inflorescence is found in Trifolium. Then regarding flowers, the flowers are shortly pedicellate. This is a photograph of the flower. Here you can see that the flower contains pedicel. So they are known as pedicellate. Then flower are also explained as bracteate because it contains the bract. This is bud of Fabaceae family member where you can see the bract. And so the flowers are known as bracteate. Then regarding symmetry of the flower, they are considered as zygomorphic. When we cut flower in the middle to make it into two equal halves, then it can be cut into only at one plane, like this. This is flower of Fabricii member, and if you want to cut the flower into two equal halves, then this is the only plane by which we can cut it into two equal halves. So such type of the symmetry is known as zygomorphic symmetry. Then the flower is considered as bisexual because it contains both the sexes, that is male sex organ and female sex organ. Here bi means two. Two sexes are present. Then flower is also known as perigynous because ovary is superior. When ovary is superior, the flower is known as perigynous. And it shows papilionaceous type of corolla. Presence of papilionaceous type of corolla is the salient feature of the Fabaceae family. Now we will see parts of flower. First we will see calyx. So this is the calyx of flower. Calyx is made up of 5 sepals, but they are united and so known as gamosepals. Here you can see the calyx. Calyx is made up of 5 sepals. So this is 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th and 5th. But all these sepals, they are united, they are fused and so known as gamosepals. Gamo means united. Then the calyx is persistent. So even after conversion of flower into fruit, we can see the calyx. And so therefore the calyx is considered as persistent. Then it is like a tube and so described as tubular. And distivation is valve distivation. After studying calyx, now we will see corolla. Corolla is made up of 5 petals. This is flower of Fabaceae family member Clitoria ternatia. This flower is dissected and here you can see 5 different petals. All petals are free, so described as polypetalous. Here poly means free and gamo means united. Then another word which is used to describe the corolla of Fabaceae family member is papilionaceous corolla. Let us see what is papilionaceous corolla. Here in this type of the corolla, the outermost largest petal is present. It is known as standard or vexillum. So this is the standard or vexillum. It encloses 2 lateral petals. They are known as wings or alli. So these are the wings or alli of the flower. And each encloses 2 partly united smaller petals. They are known as keel or carina. So these are the keel or carina. So this is the first petal. Then these are 2 second petals, which are smaller than the standard petal. And these are the smallest petals known as keel or corona. So in total, these are 5 petals. Even in this flower, we can see this is the outermost largest petal known as standard or vexillum. Another word for standard or vexillum is banner. It encloses 2 petals. They are known as wings or alli. And wings or alli are enclosing inner 2 smaller petals known as keel or carina. So these are the keel or carina. This is flower of Beautia monosperma. Here also in this flower we can see outermost petal, that is banner or standard or vexillum. It encloses 2 petals, wings, and the innermost petals, they are known as keel or carina. When we take longitudinal section of the flower, we will see standard petal at the outer side, then wing petal, and then keel or carina petal, inside which androecium and gynoecium is present. We will see it now. First we will see androecium. Androecium consists of 10 stamens. Here androecium is dissected, where we can see that the total stamens are 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. But dear students, what you have observed? 9 stamens are in a single bundle and one single stamen is present apart from this bundle. So this type of arrangement is known as diadelphous type of the stamens. Here di means 2. So the stamens, they are arranged in 2 bundles of 9 plus 1. So this is 9 and this is 1. Consider another flower of Fabaceae member. These are 9 stamens in a single bundle and this is the 10th stamen which is present in another bundle. So actually 2 bundles considered as diadelphous type of the stamens. 9 are united and 1 free. Here anthers contain 2 cells. Then regarding gynoecium, this is diagram of gynoecium. Gynoecium consists of monocarpillary unilocular superior ovary. Mono means single. So here only one carpel is present and so described as monocarpillary. This is TS of ovary, where we can see only one locule is present and inside this locule ovules are produced. So only one locule present and described as unilocular. Uni means one. Then the ovary is superior ovary. So here we can see this is the ovary and all other floral whorls, they are produced from the base of this ovary. So such type of the ovary is known as superior ovary. Then placentation is considered as marginal placentation. So this is the pod of garden pea, where we can observe the marginal placentation. Marginal placentation means all the ovules or seeds are produced in margin inside the fruit. Here the fruit is pod or legume. Here style is long and curved, as you can see here, and stigma is hairy and simple. Similarly, you can observe gynoecium here, where we can see the style is long and curved and stigma is hairy. Here you can observe the hairs on stigma. Then fruit. Fruit is legume or lomentum type. Here you can also see the fruit, which is lomentum, which show constrictions separating one seeded part. So here you can see the constrictions. Then very important thing is floral formula. So this is floral formula of Fabaceae family. First we can observe here BR dot as well as BRL dot, which shows bracts and bracteoles are present. Then this percent like symbol denotes that the flower is zygomorphic. Then this symbol denotes that the flower is bisexual. This shows male sex organ and this shows female sex organ. So both the sex organ are present and so described as bisexual. Then next are floral whorls. First is K. Here K denotes calyx. Calyx is made up of sepals. Total sepals are 5, but they are shown in a bracket. Why? Because they are united, gamosepalous, and so shown in bracket. The next floral whorl is corolla. So corolla is denoted as capital C. Total number of petals are 5, but they are not united. So here they are not shown in a bracket. Then next is androecium. Androecium is composed of 10 stamens but with 2 bundles. One bundle of 9 and one is free. So 9 are united and this is free stamen. Next one is gynoecium. Gynoecium is monocarpillary. So, a single carpel is shown here. And this gynoecium is underlined, which shows that the ovary is superior. So, this is the floral formula of Fabaceae family. Now, we will see figures of some Fabaceae family member. This is figure of Fabaceae family member, Pisum sativum, commonly known as green pea. This is flowering twig of green pea, where we can see foliaceous stipule. Then these are the leaves of the plant, where we can see that leaves are modified into tendrils. This is flower of pea plant. This is calyx of the flower, consist of 5 sepals which are united. This is longitudinal section of flower, and here you can see the open corolla. We know that the outermost petal is known as standard or vexillum, inner to that wings, next to that is keel. Next to that we can see androecium and gynoecium. So androecium consists of 10 stamens, 9 in one group, and one stamen is free. Then this is gynoecium, which is consist of only one carpel, which shows parts such as ovary, style and stigma. Then this is TS of ovary. This is longitudinal section of fruit, where we can see that the seeds are present in marginal placentation. And this is floral diagram of Fabaceae family. So this is the floral diagram with floral formula. This is mother axis of flower, and this is the bract. Next to that is calyx. Calyx consists of sepals. Then next to that is corolla. So these are petals or corolla. One is outer standard or vexilla. Then these are the wings or ali. Here we can see that one side is inner and one side is outer. And at the inner side we can see the keel. So this is calyx, this is corolla. Inside that we can see the androecium made up of 10 stamens. And next to that is gynoecium with only one carpel and one locule. So this is regarding floral diagram of Fabaceae family. With this, we have completed morphological as well as floral characters of Fabaceae family. In next video, we will see plants of economic importance of Fabaceae family. Thank you.